Hey, what's up everyone? This is Volo coming at you again with another episode of Volo Video, the real life lowriding stories that I've got to tell, stuff that I think you'd want to hear. I'm talking about a shoot I did back in March 2005, right? Taking it back almost a couple decades ago, pretty close to it. So a red 59 Impala, the owner was Martin, right? He lived actually not too far from me in San Bernardino. He was a UPS driver for many years, made good money. He was a single guy, bachelor, living it up. He had some nice rides, including that 59 Impala. He wasn't one to really go to the lowriding cruises, the lowrider shows. He just did his own thing, you know? He was a little bit older than me, but he was just one cool dude. And to this day, we still keep in touch. And we still look back at this photo shoot that we did. So I reached out to Martin and I was like, hey, I wanna do a shoot on your car. And the first thing that he asked me was, well, how much am I getting paid? So unfortunately the magazine didn't pay the car owners that we shot. They didn't get paid for it. It was just more for bragging rights, an honor to be in the magazine. So I kinda had to talk Martin into doing it. And I knew that if I was gonna get him to commit to it, that the shoot would have to be great. It would have to be spectacular. So I came up with an idea. Again, you know Volo, looking for those best locations. Why not shoot on the 210 freeway? It wasn't opened yet. It was a brand new freeway. There were no potholes. There was no damage, no graffiti. It was perfect. And I ran the idea by Martin and he was like, well, if you think you can do it, let's do it. So I lived in San Bernardino, that area known as the Inland Empire, about an hour east of LA. It was blowing up at the time, right? There was a lot of people from LA moving eastward to try to save some living costs. You know, the housing prices were a lot less out there than it was in LA. So the Inland Empire was growing. And with that came the need to build a new freeway. This freeway was a little farther north from Interstate 10, but it paralleled it, Interstate 10. And yeah, that freeway was a good idea. It definitely helped relieve some traffic on the 10 by putting in the 210. So the 210 was getting built and it was pretty much was about ready to be opened up to the public. It was done. The freeway was done back in March 2005, and you know Volo, I'm always looking for a good backdrop, a good location to shoot some cars. You know, I never shot in the studio, so for me, my studio was our lands, right? Trying to find, you know, that perfect backdrop to complement the car I was shooting. And I'm telling you guys, those of you who shoot cars, you other lowriding photographers, take the time, get those wheels spinning, find those great backdrops to complement the car you're shooting, because it just, the car speaks for itself, of course, but if you find a real cool backdrop, it's just gonna make that picture stand out. It'll look really nice. You know, and if you pick a model, if you're gonna have a model there, my suggestion is get one that's classy, right? She doesn't have to be raunchy and, you know, it doesn't have to get all crazy like that. Pick a classy model, one who knows her poses, she dresses nice, that's gonna stand out a lot more too, among the masses, you know. So anyway, getting back to the story, I started getting a crew together, different heads were a part of this whole shoot. We didn't just get one model, we got two models, right? And they were big time models in the low riding scene. Natalie Keene from the Bay Area and Nikki Zeno, the one that had been on many covers for Lowrider magazine. Nikki and I, we had gone back quite a few years. We had a good friendship and I reached out to her, told her about the idea that I had for this shoot, doing it on the freeway, and she was down. She said, let's do it. So I had Jose from Unique's Car Club. He was working for a city in Orange County at the time, and he was able to bring some additional equipment to kind of make it all look legit and make sure that safety was there and, you know, everything rolled smoothly, so props out to Jose too. But anyway, getting back to the story, the day came after lots of planning. We entered the freeway. There was an area that we were able to enter. It was not closed off. It wasn't any kind of secure barriers we had to go around or anything like that. We did it in a proper way. And I'll tell you, fast forward, when we left there, we left it the way we found it, you know, no damage or anything. And in fact, when we finally did drive onto the freeway, it was kind of surreal because there was no traffic out there, no sound. The way the freeway was being made, it was inset down lower than the surrounding area. The surface streets and whatnot, they were up higher. So this was an inset area, kind of a desert area, and we were out of sight from anyone. It was just surreal being down on a multi-lane freeway in Southern California, and it was so quiet out there. It was crazy, but so cool. And after we got there, about a half hour in, the sheriff's helicopter started flying around us. It was circling us, you know, and we thought maybe we were gonna get kicked out. They were gonna ask us to leave. I was waiting for the pilot to get on the horn and say, hey, you need to exit immediately. But I actually looked up, we were all waving at him, and I could see the pilot wave back. I think he was just checking to make sure we weren't doing any vandalizing, nothing crazy. He flew around 2-3 times and then he flew off, and that was it. No police showed up, everything was all good, and we stayed there till sunset. We were probably out there about 2 or 3 hours. But anyway, yeah, what a cool backdrop. We had the 59 Impala just parked blocking the lanes. We had the two models there. We had Martine even in some of the shots sitting there with, you know, in the driver's seat with the two girls behind him. I know he was liking it. You know, a lot of the support crew that was there, their cars were all parked like they were driving on the freeway. They were like stopped, almost as if Martine had like stopped in the middle of the freeway and blocked traffic. So it just made it a cool effect. And I remember so many people, once they saw the photos, they thought that we actually did stop on a live freeway and stop traffic. And I had to tell them, nope, that wasn't the case. So I had a lot of people saying, oh, you photoshopped it. How'd you photoshop it? Nope, it wasn't Photoshop. It was the real deal. So such a memorable shoot. You know, even to this day, Martine and I, we keep in touch, and he's got some of the pictures framed on his wall. It was a day to remember. We had such a good time. Definitely one for the books, and I wanted to share that story with you guys. So hope you enjoyed it. Take care, and I will see you on the next episode of Volo Video. Peace.